Hey, everybody, and welcome back to this episode of the Mortgage Rundown. As always, I'm here with Jason Obradovich, CIO of New American Funding. Hey, Jason, how have you been doing the last few weeks?
Good, Alexis. How about yourself?
Been doing pretty good, hanging in there. So I know a few weeks back, the FOMC meeting happened. So can you tell me what's been going on in the last few weeks? Like, what did the Federal Reserve have to say?
Yeah, you know, a really important meeting, you know, that we just had. And so it wasn't necessarily that the market was expecting the Fed to do anything with rates or their buying program. What they did was they affirmed what they were already doing. And so they came out and basically said, look, we're going to continue to buy treasuries. We're going to continue to buy mortgage-backed securities. We're going to support the liquidity of the market just to make sure the markets are functioning properly. And then the really big thing that they said, and this, you know, this has a lot of ramifications, is they said, look, we're going to keep interest rates low at least through 2022. So through 2020, 2021, and 2022. So that is really forecasting that we should expect to be in this rate environment for a very long time. And so that does a couple of things. You know, it really assures the market that this is not a temporary thing, not necessarily just COVID, but there's this market disruption. And one of the things that really, you know, scares investors is, you know, the Fed might come in, but they might step back out. And so people would be very fearful of stepping in and investing right now. But when the Fed gives you that kind of guarantee, it really assures not just short-term investors, but long-term investors that they're going to provide liquidity and keep rates at, you know, at these levels for a long period of time.
Okay, so what about on the liquidity side? We've heard that some loans just like don't have as much interest anymore. So can you update us on that front?
Yeah, that's a, you know, it's a good question. So, you know, what happened after March, or right as the, you know, the whole world and especially United States, there was all of these shutdowns, is the investment community just said, you know, I don't want any risk. Anything that's even perceived to have risk. That could be high quality borrowers, that could be borrowers with certain, you know, credit issues. But what happened immediately back in March was people said, look, I don't want any investments that have any credit risk at all. And people just, it got shut off right away, right? Those markets seized. And so there was no liquidity. Now things have started to open back up. We have a little better estimate on, you know, the impact to the economy. And so now what you have the Federal Reserve coming out and saying, look, we're gonna support the markets at least through 2022. That gives a lot of assurance to investors that, look, you can make longer term investments, whether they be high credit borrowers and maybe even to some degree lower credit borrowers. And so to answer your question, we are seeing investors starting to open up the credit box a little bit. We're nowhere near where we were before the crisis, but it is starting to open up a little bit.
So going off of that, looking ahead, when do you expect markets to return back to normal? I mean, I don't think there's going to be an exact answer, but when can we expect some normalcy again?
Yeah, when we return to normal is a tough question. So if you were to go back to 2008, right, we had the whole credit markets, the whole world had to deal with this whole mortgage meltdown. And I think people were always wondering, when will we return back to that normal? And the answer was never. We were never going to return back to that normal because there were just certain mortgage products that never should have been originated in the first place. But where we were pre-crisis was in a really good spot. There were non-QM loans were trading, people with credit issues, like, you know, recent foreclosures or bankruptcies, those loans were trading. They were able to get, you know, they were able to get loans even if they had a recent foreclosure or bankruptcy. And so those markets were actually functioning really well. When do we actually get back to where we were? You know, that's a tough question. It will not be in 2020. 2021 would be, really be anyone's guess, but probably somewhere in 2021. It really depends on when everyone's life returns back to normal, right? When can people function as they did before? We're not there yet, so it's really hard to gauge when those markets will trade like they were before. But, you know, if I'm a betting man, I would say 2021 sometime, maybe a year from now.
Well, only time will tell. We'll see.
Absolutely. Like every month is going to, the world's going to look very different than it does right now. And the capital market's going to look very different than what it does right now.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, that's all I have today. I appreciate you hopping on to update all our viewers. This was a lot of great information. And yeah, I appreciate your time.
Yeah, thanks, you. I enjoyed it. We'll talk to you soon.
All right. Sounds good. Bye, Jason.
Bye. are going to stand behind the economy. So when you, I'm sorry, I'm getting a phone call right now.
How dare they? Don't they know we're doing the mortgage rundown?